How would you say that a person, a light worker, can love themselves more, love themselves into those experiences, the presence of joy, the beingness of joy?
That's kind of a hard one.
It is, isn't it? I know. I'm asking you. Please tell me now, because I don't know.
I think there are a few ways, but one of the ways I'm focusing on presently is languaging, inner languaging, the things that we say to ourselves about ourselves, the things that we say about other people, and which is outer languaging, and just the words that we use, and how we're actually programming ourselves on the daily, on the hourly, every single minute, just by allowing ourselves to say certain things. And if we can kind of start by cleaning that up first and changing the way we speak about ourselves, even if we don't feel it yet on the inside, we don't feel that sense of love or that joy. If we start to speak that way anyway, the body, mind, and spirit falls into alignment with that. You know, I'm constantly talking about how the body is always listening, and it is. And we always tell our students that the body is the most psychic instrument that we have, and it really does respond to things like sound and things like intention. And so if we start changing the way we think, and even if we don't feel it yet, but we're saying to ourselves, I am divine. I am that I am is what I am. Like, just start saying those things. Change the languaging of your inner life, and it will start showing up in your heart, in your spirit, in your emotions, and it'll start to express out from there. That's one of the things it's one of the tools that I think that we can use. And the other thing is we just need to understand and get right with the reality of who it is that we are. I think a lot of people lack fundamental understanding of who they are, which is hard to define, because when you drill down into it, it's super amorphous and you can't really define who it is that we are. But I can say as an absolute that we're powerful. I can say that we were created in perfection, not imperfection. We were created in space, perfection, by a perfect creator. I can say that. And we were created right alongside with the archangels. We're powerful. Our souls are powerful. That's who we are. We have to understand that. To love ourselves truly and then to love others, we have to understand that that's who we are and get out of our own way in this sticky material reality that likes to ensnare us in traps and get us thinking that this is all there is. And that's where the depression comes in, and that's where the futility comes in, and that's where the anger comes in. Woo, we got to pivot away from that and point our interest back to who it is that we truly are.
That was something. Our souls are powerful.
Oh. They are. They are. Do you feel that? And that's another thing I like to say. Do you feel that? Mm-hmm. Because a lot of people say, well, prove that to me, that there's a God. And all I say is, did you feel that?
Yeah.
Does the soul bear witness to that? Do you get what I think Lisa Robinette calls truth chills? Because your body will tell you, that's true. My soul bears witness to that. Follow that. That never steers you wrong. Mm-hmm. Does it, Tricia Carr?
No, it does not. Yes, amen to all of that. That you just spoke that upon us. You all who are listening, we're saying, did you feel that? Crystal's saying, did you feel that? I want you to receive this. It is, if you want to think about witchcraft and all that kind of stuff, well, words, as Crystal is saying, are powerful. And she just spoke that upon us. And she said, our souls are powerful. Now, of course, in the falsehood behind witchcraft is thinking that someone can do something to you that you don't accept. That is in defiance to a fundamental truth, which is free will, universal free will. So in this moment, if you will use the universal truth, the universal law of free will, and say, accept that Crystal cast that upon us, she spoke that upon us, our souls are powerful. Your soul is powerful. I receive it. And I say, yes, it is. And I can feel that power. I can feel it bursting out of me right now.
Me too. I feel it. And that's why I usually say, do you want it? Then say yes. You got to agree with it. Mm-hmm. It's not just me saying that it's true. If your soul is bearing witness that it's true, you got to say, yes, I receive the blessing of that. Yes, I receive the empowerment of that. And yes, I choose to walk and live and have my being in the truth and the reality of that. You have to move in the direction of it. It's not just people telling you that. That's what jostles you out of the stuck place, or the stuck mind, or the stuck life, is feeling the vibration of what's true about you, and what's true about me, and what's true about this planet, this beautiful, beautiful planet. Like, feeling your way to the wholeness of it. That's what we all need to do. That's some light work right there.
That is. What you're saying about, you know, inner speaking, the inner languaging and the outer languaging, you know, it is a very magical thing. Obviously, if you say something like, I am a millionaire, and you are feeling dissonance with that, you're just like, no, I'm not. But you could actually say I'm a millionaire. And by experiencing like, well, there is a time space reality where I am, and I choose to feel that right now. So we can see. But the point is the truth feeling of it. And you're actually activating the frequency in you. And we can start with the inner languaging or the outer languaging or the fake it till you make it, which actually seems very, you know, like a disparaging kind of thing. It seems like when we say fake, that means it's false. But someone in the lab, when I was saying this, I was actually teaching in the lab, and one of the members said, affirm it till you learn it. And I mean the learning all the way down through the mind, body, and spirit. And you can use any part of that triune being. You can use the body to hold your posture up straight and say, and then say, I am worthy and I am powerful. And then you feel it. You know, you can enter in any way because all of us is holy. Every part of us is powerful.
Right. And it really is a triune. We are a Trinity being. You know, in the Bible, it says, let us make man in our image. And we are made in a Trinity image. And we have the consciousness, we have the subconscious, and the feeling part is so very important that you're talking about, which is the transmission of the affirmation. Like, we can walk around all day trying to have affirmations, or we have vision boards, but it really is getting into the feeling. That's why I'm saying, can you feel that? Like, mm-hmm. Do you get the truth chills of that, and holding on to that for as long as possible so that the transmission can actually leave the consciousness and be received by the subconscious, which is the creator of the reality. It's finding ways to be in the space of that. I don't want to get too esoteric or metaphysical. It's about finding ways into the energy of that and staying there for as long as possible. And it's okay, by the way, to just take care of yourself in that space. It's okay to just bask in the vibration of all that loveliness all within yourself until such time as you're ready to let that express out or spill out into the community, into the people at the Starbucks, into your commute. It's okay to just let that love fill you up. A lot of us need that kind of self-care, and we don't do that. We take care of other people. We spend our time focusing on other people. But if we can do it for ourselves, then that's how we grow the light. That's how it begins to shine.